We came to know it as the Shadow. It sounds mundane, doesn't it? Unassuming. None of us had any notion what it was or where it came from, which only deepened our fear of it. I know what comes after in most stories. Gathered up a party of misfit heroes and set off to vanquish evil, did I? I didn't. Never even left the village. Mine's a different sort of story, remember? Full of sadness and sentiment and people very precious to me, if not the great ballads. I lost a few of them that night. Mom and Dad both died in that first storm. A handful of other folks besides. I can speak of it plainly now, but in the moment, well, it took ages to reassemble the shattered pieces of our lives, and things could never truly go back to the way they were. Yet, the shadow passed. And we lived on. What else could we do? What else can we ever? They say time heals all wounds. Not so sure myself. Dulls the pain, maybe? Mornings out on the lake became part of my new routine. They made for pleasant distractions, full of songbirds trilling and waves lapping and Graham's easy company. But even the sweetest distractions only that. Truth was, the shadow had settled deep within our mountains, and coils of darkness began creeping into our homes like ivy up the old walls of the inn. We wouldn't be able to ignore it much longer. Thank you.
I
Didn't know what to make of Thomas right away. Kelsey had fallen head over heels, of course. He was a man, after all, and one we hadn't known our whole lives. Strange to recall that morning, considering what would happen between us.
Mm-hmm.